Blessed is our God, always, now, and ever, unto ages of ages.
Amen. Whosoever dwelleth under the defense of the High Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say unto the Lord, Thou art my hope, my strong hope, my God, in Him will I trust. For He delivered thee from the snare of the hunter and from the noisome pestilence. He shall defend thee under His wings, and thou shalt be safe under His feathers. Faithfulness and truth shall be thy shield and buckler. Thou shalt not be afraid of thy any terror by night, nor for the arrow that fleeth by day, for the pestilence that walketh in the darkness, nor for the sickness that destroyeth in the noonday. 1,000 shall fall behind thee, and 10,000 in thy right hand. But it shall not come nigh thee. Yea, with thine eyes shalt thou behold and see reward of the ungodly. For thou, Lord, art my hope. Thou set thy house of defense very high, where shall no evil happen upon thee, neither shall any plague come nigh on thy dwelling. For He saith, give His angels charge over it and keepeth thy way. They shall bear thee in thy hands, for thou hurt thy foot against the stone. Thou shalt go up the lion and utter the young lion, and the dragon shall thou tread under thy feet. Because he hath set foot and love upon, therefrom will I deliver him. I shall set him up, because he hath named me by name. He hath called upon me, and I will hear him. Yea, I am in trouble, I will deliver him, and bring him into honor. With long life will I satisfy him, and show him my salvation.
Blessed art thou, O Lord.
And purify me by thy loving kindness.
Amen. Christ our God, who from the Virgin didst draw forth upon the world, through her making us children of the light, have mercy upon us.
There is none holy like unto thee, O Lord, my God, who hast exalted the horn of the faithful, O good one, and hast established them upon the rock of thy compassion.
Truly all things are vanity, and life is but a shadow of a dream. For in vain doth everyone born of earth disquiet himself, as it saith in the scripture, when we have acquired the world, then do we take up our dwelling in the grave, where kings and beggars are the same. Wherefore, Christ God, give rest to thy servant departed this life, for as much as loves mankind.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, O Holy Theotokos, forsake me not during the years of my life, nor make me dependent upon human protection, but do thou defend me and have mercy upon me.
As I beheld this sea of life surging high with the tempest of temptation, I set my course towards thy tranquil haven and cried aloud to thee. Lead thou my life forth from corruption, O most merciful one.
Yeah.
yet one moment only, and death shall supplement them all. But in the light of thy countenance, O Christ, and in the sweetness of thy beauty, give rest unto him who thou hast chosen, for as much as thou art lovest mankind.
Woe is me, what manner of ordeal doth the soul endure when it is departed from the body? Woe is me, how many then are its tears, and there is none to show compassion. Turning its eyes to the angels, it supplicates in vain. Stretching out its hands to men, it findeth none to help. Wherefore, may it be, my beloved brethren, meditating on the brevity of our life, let us beseech of Christ rest for her, who hath departed hence, and for our souls a great mercy.
All immortal things are vanity, and exist after, not after death. Riches endureth not, neither doth glory accompany on the way. For when death cometh, all these things vanish utterly. Wherefore, let us cry unto Christ the immortal King. Give rest in the dwelling place of all those who rejoice in him who is departed among us.
Where is the desire of the world? Where is the display of transient mortals? Where are the gold and the silver? Where is the multitude of household servants and their clamor? All our dust, all our ashes, all our shadows, but come, let us cry aloud unto the deathless King, O Lord, of thine eternal good things, account her worthy, who hath departed from among us, giving unto her rest in the blessedness which she groweth not old.
I called to men to the mind of the prophet as he cried, I am earth and ashes. I looked again in the graves, beheld the bones laid bare, and I said, who then is the king of the warrior, the rich man or the needy, the upright or the sinner? Yet, O Lord, give rest unto thy servant with thy righteousness.
Thy creating command was my origin and my foundation, for it was thy pleasure to fashion me out of nature visible and invisible, a living creature. From the earth thou didst shape my body, and didst give me a soul by thy divine and quickening breath. Wherefore, O Christ, give rest to thy servant, Josephine, in the land of the living, in the habitation of the just.
When in the beginning thou didst create man after thine own image and likeness, thou didst set him in the paradise to reign over thy creatures. But when beguiled by the malice of the devil, he tasted of the food, he began a transgression of thy commandments. For which cause, O Lord, thou didst condemn him to return again unto earth, whence he was taken and entreated and repose.
I weep and I wail when I think upon that, and behold, our beauty fashioned after the image of God, lying in the tomb, disfigured, dishonored, bereft of form. O Marvel, what is this mystery which doth befall us? Why have we been given over unto corruption? And why have we been wedded unto death? Truly, as it is written, by the command of God, who giveth the departed rest, remember us, O Lord, when thou comest into thy kingdom.
Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven.
Blessed are they that mourn, for they shall be comforted.
Blessed are the meek, for they shall inherit the earth.
Blessed are they that do hunger and thirst for righteousness' sake, for they shall be filled.
Blessed are the merciful, for they shall obtain mercy. A citizen of paradise, O Christ, thou didst make of the thief who, because of repentance, upon the cross cried unto thee, remember me, make thou me a sinner, worthy also by the same.
Blessed are the pure in heart, for thou shalt see God. O to thee, remember me. Also, Lord, when thou comest into thy kingdom.
Blessed are the peacemakers, for they shall be called children of God. O thou who rulest over the soul's bodies, in whose hand in the our breath, the consolation of the afflicted, in the land of the just, rest unto thy servant, whom thou hast raised from us.
Blessed are they which are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. May Christ give thee rest in the land of the living, and open unto thee the gates of paradise, and make thee a citizen of his kingdom, and give thee remission of those things wherein thou in life hast sinned, O thou who lovest Christ.
Blessed are ye when men shall revile you, and persecute you, and shall all manner of evil against you, falsely for my name's sake. Let us go forth and gaze into the tomb. Man is naked bones, food for the worms and the stench. We shall learn what are the riches and comeliness and beauty and strength.
Rejoice and be exceedingly glad, for great is your reward in heaven. For so persecuted they the prophets which were before you. Let us hearken unto what the Almighty cried. Woe unto those who seek to behold the terrible day of the Lord. For lo, it is darkness, for all things shall be tried with fire.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit. Him who hath no beginning in birth or cause of Father, I worship him who is the only begotten Son. I glorify unto the Holy Spirit, who shineth together with the Father and Son, I sing praises.
Lesson
of the Epistle of the Holy Apostle.
that which are asleep. Yet ye sorrow not, even as others which have no hope. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so them also say sleep in Jesus will God bring with him. For this we say unto you by the word of the Lord, that we who are alive and remain unto the coming of the Lord shall not prevent them who are asleep. For the Lord himself shall descend from heaven with the shout, and with the voice of an archangel, and with the trumpet of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise first. Then we who are alive and remain shall be caught up together with him in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. And so we ever be with the Lord.
Peace be to you that lead us.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Blessed is he who cometh, chosen and taken home.
Wisdom and tenderness near the only gospel, peace be unto all.
And with thy spirit.
The reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint John.
Glory to thee, O Lord, glory to thee.
Let us attend. The Lord said to the Jews who came unto him, truly, truly, I say to you, he who hears my word and believes in him who sent me has everlasting life. He does not come into judgment, but has passed from death to life. Truly, truly, I say to you, the hour is coming and now is, when the dead will hear the voice of the Son of God and live. For as the Father has life in himself, so he has granted the Son to have life in himself, and has given him authority to execute the judgment, because he is the Son of Man. Do not marvel at this, for the hour is coming when all who are in the tombs will hear his voice and come forth. Those who have done good to the resurrection of life, and those who have done evil to the resurrection of judgment. I can do nothing on my own authority. As I hear, I judge, and my judgment is just, because I seek not my own will, church but it helped all the Orthodox who came from the Middle East and Europe to settle in Edmonton. And one of those families, for sure, you know I'm talking about, Josephine and her husband who came here and started their life, their new life in Edmonton. You know that we have been saying the prayers for a few minutes, and these prayers, they tell us a lot about the last day, about the judgment of Christ, about how the soul, where the soul is going when it departs from the body. In other terms, what we're seeing here and what we're saying is that Josephine's life is a book. It's a book. If you want to read her life, there is a lot to read. There is a lot to understand, and not only stories, but experiences. And for sure, the cross she bear in her life to be with Christ and to be with a witness to Him, to the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ. The wisdom of today's service and of Christ teaching to us that, you know, the Father from the beginning, who existed, who ever existed, there is no time that He did not exist. The Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, existed with the Father from the beginning as well, with no beginning. And you heard in the Gospel that the Father, God Himself, gave the power to the Son to judge the world. You know that we're going to celebrate the Nativity of our Lord in a few days, and Christ became like us, humble, and He became like us, weak, and He became like us, thirsty and hungry. But at the end of the day, this is not the phenomenon. At the end of the day, He will be the Christ sitting on a throne of judgment, judging the earth. And that's what Christ has said in the Gospel today. That at the end of the age, He will come and judge all the living and the dead. As you heard in the Epistle of St. Paul, that whoever is in the tomb will come back to life, the spirit will come back to the body, and the body will take life again, and will be going, as Christ has promised us, to life without judgment, which is according to our deeds and according to our life. My brothers and sisters, there is a lot to say about this mystery, but in brief, whatever we do is kept in God's mind. Whatever good we do in life is kept in His hand. Whatever bad, we're judged for it. So all the good deeds we've done, that's where the balance is gonna be, is gonna take place at the end of days when we are judged. Today, Josephine, as I have said yesterday, the moment I met her in her house 3 years ago, three and a half years ago, she met me and my wife with hospitality, with laugh, with smile. It's like you're feeling at your home. You're not away, few thousand miles away from your parents or brothers and sisters, but that's your home. So this is how every Christian and disciple of Christ should be. And later on, anytime I call her, anytime I visit her, I bring the sacraments to her house, she always welcomes us and welcomes me with this big heart. Today, as we say, she is in a better place. She is with the saints. That's what we prayed for today. With the saints, give rest, O Lord, to the soul of thy departed servant. And that's what we should always pray. And I ask all her children and everyone to do good in her memory, to help the poor, the needy, the church, to support the church in her memory, that all her sins may be forgiven and God will give her rest with the saints. One of the St. John Chrysostom, one of the great theologians in our church, has said, anything you do in loving memory of your departed ones will count and will help the soul reach its destination. I mean, it's glory. So this is really important, the moment when we pray, you come to church 40 days to offer the divine liturgy in her memory.